When I was a little girl, I saw a skydiver on the TV. And I was fascinated, and I saw it, and I thought, I want to do that one day. Finally, for my 22nd birthday, I thought, you know what? I'm going to do it. I'm going to go jump out of an airplane. The wind is blowing so hard, and it's just a thrill, and you're thinking, what am I doing? Why am I doing this? And then once you get under canopy and it's quiet and you're floating through the air, and it's just amazing. It's just an amazing feeling. It's hard to explain to anybody that hasn't done it. I was hooked from the very first jump. I'm a recovering addict, and many years ago I found myself in a situation. I felt really stuck, and I was stuck there for a really long time, and I didn't know how to get out. And even if I did know how to get out, I don't know that I would have had the strength or the courage to take those steps at the time. It just takes over your life. And even though you think, you know, during the day, I got this, I'm okay. I'm just fine. I'm just like anybody else. And you're not, you know, and you realize that, and then you go, oh boy, now I'm in over my head. Now what? Early morning, I was on my way home, and I crossed the center line and got into a head-on car collision. By the grace of God, the other woman was not severely injured. I was in pretty bad shape. Ruptured bladder, collapsed lung, broken ribs, broken fingers, broken pelvis in 5 places, crushed ankles. So I was at Parkview Randalia for a total of 12 weeks. Excellent. They were so good to me there. The staff, the nurses, the doctors. It's amazing to be on the other side and actually receive that care. I don't remember anything for the first couple of days. I woke up in the ICU and I opened my eyes and I thought, okay, this is God's not so subtle way of saying it's time. I had fallen away from my faith for a long time, and that really gave me time to bring God back into my life. I mean, I needed him. I needed him more than ever. And I had to make a choice right then. And I made that decision right there I left my home and my boyfriend and my friends and the lifestyle, everything in the past. I just left it. And I never looked back. So I met my husband skydiving. It's fun to have a husband, a mate that has the same hobbies as you, right? We were actually doing water training for skydiving, and so we were at a pool. He took off his shirt and I thought, my goodness, he has as many scars as I do. What happened to this poor man? And so that was kind of my first attraction, like, well, you've been through a lot of stuff, just as I've been through a lot of stuff. But then I find out he does car stunts, which I thought was incredible. Wait, you crash cars on purpose? I just do that on accident. So we've actually counted our scars together, which is not a contest you want to win, but we're still accumulating them. So we were at a skydiving event. Skydivers would call them skydiving boogies, right? And we had been jumping all day. And they're like, do you guys want to do another one? Okay, yeah, we'll squeeze one more in before sunset. So it comes time to jump, right? And I'm last out of the plane, and everybody's out, and I jump out, and I'm flying down to the formation, and these goggles were so dirty. And I thought, this formation does not look anything like what we practice on the ground. What are these guys doing? And I saw my husband in the middle of a circle holding a sign that said, will you marry me, Suzanne? I gave him thumbs up and gave him a kiss and in the air. And then when we landed, he pulled out the ring and asked me to marry him. And of course I said yes. I'm a business intelligence developer, so I work on business analytics, reports, dashboards for executives, to nurse leaders, to pharmacy, to help them make business decisions throughout the organization. I've always been interested in IT. I went to school for computer information systems. I was on the Willow team or the pharmacy team for 8 years, I believe, and an opportunity came up on business intelligence. And I thought for a really long time, it was a really hard decision because my pharmacy team was the best team I'd ever worked with. But I made the decision to switch teams. And at the same time, another coworker, she joined the team and we had to go to Epic in Wisconsin for training. So we buddied up and drove, you know, 6 hours and spent the whole week together. And we had a lot of great conversations. And I shared that my husband and I had tried for a really long time to have children and weren't able to. So we came back from training and sat next to each other in our desks. And a year later, she came to work and said, I know someone who's pregnant. And they're struggling and they're looking to put her up for adoption. Do you think you and your husband, and I immediately said yes, and I thought, well, I should probably talk to my husband. And so we went from not knowing anything to 3 weeks later, baby Evelyn was born, and it all came so quickly. And all of a sudden, she was here. I'm so blessed. What a miracle. What a great God we have. Just the different little decisions that I made that brought me to this point. That decision to go out that night, you know, sounds weird, but it was my blessing in disguise. You know, I heard a quote recently, faith doesn't make things easy, it makes things possible. And I think that is something I want to relay to anybody that's having struggles out there now is take it one day at a time. Take it 1 hour at a time if you have to. There's a better life worth living. There's a life out there past the struggles. And here I am. I would have never in a million years thought that I would have the opportunity and the family and the career and daughter and home and that I have today.